hello YouTube. So I said I was going to go on to show you what I take on my field trips, and in order to do that I have created some forms myself, but they don't look as clean as Pocket Foil Primary, who sells really clean version of what I usually made myself. So she has a packet up, I want to say it's 45 pages, and in those 45 pages she gives multiple choices of stuff, but a couple of things that she has are like permission slip, which our campus already provides for us, so I just kind of copied and pasted to her claim form and they look really cute. And then also she has tons of reminders. So the first thing that I do is I did go through her file, and she has a checklist of the items that you might want to cover, like maybe like a month before, like making sure you get the permission slips out and making sure you have the chaperones. She has like every little thing that you can think of, she has it. Then also another thing that she has that I actually didn't get, I just kind of copied it from my own roster, was like emergency contacts. And sometimes, as much as like the office tries to keep that information updated, it not always happens that way. And if you're a teacher, you know what I'm talking about. So sometimes us as teachers, we have like direct numbers in our cell phone. I know I do, because I actually offer my cell phone to parents and they are able to text me. So I put in the cell phone that I usually use to communicate with them, although I do have Class Dojo. So she has a nice form, and I updated that and made sure it was on the binder that I take, or the clipboard that I take for the field trip. Also, this is the field trip list that I was talking about. So she has like things to do before the field trip, things to do during the field trip, and things to bring on the trip. So that's kind of cool, because before I just had like post-its here and post-its over there, and Maria Hernandez is crazy, so all the post-its got lost all of a sudden and it wasn't very clean. But one form that I did have before that she has a super clean copy of are the chaperone list, and she has like a list like of 8 groups, 6 groups, 4 groups, and I think the last one is like 2 groups. So it's kind of cool, and she just does an amazing job with that. So anyway, she has that, reminders, and also one thing that is really neat and I've never done in this form is she has like a thank you card for them. So if I can quickly like scroll to this, oh yeah, it says, field trips are hectic, but field trips are fun. Without volunteers like you, they couldn't be done. And it says, thank you so much for chaperoning. And I put Mrs. Hernandez, and gave them a chocolate bar. So that's one thing, like usually I gave them like a little $5 gift card or something, just a candy. But I never gave them something like this. So I actually copied in color paper and handed it to the chaperones. They were really, really grateful. So we just went on the field trip this Friday, and it was really fun just to see that they were greatly appreciated, especially because, you know, they donate their time to spend time with not only their child, but helping us with other children in their group. So that was kind of cool. She also has like other stuff, like the bus seating chart, but that is also provided by our district. But because I'm very special about stuff, I actually copied the bus seating chart that the office provides, copied and pasted, I want to say it's a snip clip or something, and then I pasted it onto her sheet, which looks much more cleaner version than what our district provides. Just saying. Anyway, so that's that. I also, when I came home, I like to give my parents or chaperones like an essentials bag, not necessarily a first aid kit, but an essentials bag. And in that bag, I usually use a Ziploc bag and then just put like items like maybe band-aids, tissue, or whatever. But I'm going to show you. Well, I went to Dollar Tree with one of my colleagues on Thursday before the field trip. She said, what about these little bags? They're so cute. And they come in a pack of 2. And I thought it was cute, so we went ahead and bought the pack. So 2 of these for $1. And that's how they came in a little pack. And then I decided to use the smaller version of the bag to put in a gallon-sized bag, because sometimes kids get sick in the bus. And yeah, I've been there, done that. So now I know. So I put this, also some gloves, and I put in like 6 band-aids or so. And I just keep them here because they're kind of flat and you can just put it in. Also, my colleague said, why don't we just put chopstick? And we did, so it's brand new in there. And this is actually one of the bags that my parents took, but they didn't use any of this. So As long as we keep everything updated, it should be fine for our next field trip. And this bigger version, of course, this was in here. I have like hand sanitizer, tissue, because we were all sick, including myself. And then I also give them a pen just so we can update their chaperone list, because at the end not all the kids end up going or whatever, and then they can end up crossing out whoever wasn't in their list. And then the other thing is, which they did have, we put like 6 mints, and now there's only 1 mint in here, so that's a good thing. So just mints, because we're in the bus for a long ride and I just feel like it's an essential thing to have with them. So that so number one, your forms, and making sure that everything is updated and that you are nice and covered in terms of medications with your students, because some of them will need them. So this actually gets you to that, and she actually has forms for that as well. So as long as you have all your forms up to date, make sure the busing is ready, make sure you schedule with the field trip or whatever. So anyway, that number two, the essential bag is super important. Not only, I mean, they might, like a lot of them, they didn't use it, but the parent also feels like, oh my gosh, this teacher has it together, which I do sometimes. But the fact that they know that we care and that they feel protected, and you're like, oh my gosh, she's ready. So anyway, the bag, and in that bag, when I was putting it together, I'm like, I need something else. So of course I went and just Googled field trip, cut a little picture or whatever, and then paste it onto Word and made copies of it. I'll show you what it looked like. And obviously this is not my clip, so, but that's what it looked like. And then I just printed, laminated on my basic laminator from Amazon, and it's pretty sturdy, so I just attached it to that, and they had a nice little baggie to go with them with the field trip. Then in my backpack, my small backpack, I just always, of course, take my wallet. I did put these in here until, you know, I gave it to them, but later on, I replaced it with my students' medication. Also, I carry this, which I really love, instead of the hand sanitizer. I really like these wipes. And then I also carry like tons and tons of tissues with me, because like I said, I feel so very sick. And I also carry a pen. And I carry like my little essential bag, which has my own medication and like a lipstick, lip balm, hair ties. And I also put hair ties on there, so I guess they use them as well. So I also put some in their baggies. And just like a little mirror, which was given by one of my good friends, by the way, from Putty. Anyway, so that's it. That's all. I put everything in here. I put in my lunch, and I make sure I have water, enough water, because sometimes the kids don't bring it or whatever, and then I end up giving my own. I also carry water under the bus because they always need it. And last but not least, this, because I end up taking tons of pictures. And not only, this thing was awesome, by the way, not only did I use it, but my two other colleague friends used it as well, and we were good to go, because we were taking tons of pictures and videos. And you need this, believe me, you're gonna need this. And that's it, that wraps it up. I just wanted to go on and make sure that you did get this video, because I promised it on my vlog. If you haven't seen it, please go and check it. Go ahead and press like, like if you like this video. Go ahead and subscribe. I have, I think it's like my 10th vlog or whatever, so go ahead and subscribe. Take care, bye. Bye guys.